we can understand, but we need to vote for it.
Okay.
All right.
So.
One.
Yeah.
So
all right.
What can I expect? What is
Samus wants to be high because Samus's aerials can like kind of keep Kirby in the air. Samus is above Kirby, and Revan doesn't want to let Samus be directly above him. So Revan's gonna try to approaching from the side with like backers and stuff. I don't think we're gonna see a lot of up tilts by Revan. Yeah, that's what we're gonna see. Like Revan.
Samus should get caught on the ground, right?
Yeah. Samus doesn't want to be in the ground. Not necessarily because it's like super bad for Samus, but because Samus performs way better in this matchup when Samus is in the air and Kirby's in the air. And all right, so Kirby is up there, or up tilt's amazing, obviously, but Kirby doesn't really get the crazy up tilt like punishes he gets on the character.
Right, got a bit of a way to do it.
Yeah, like Revan, we saw how like Revan went in versus Zuko because he knew there was such a skill gap difference. I feel like he kind of underestimates the skill gap difference in this match because he's playing like, very safe.
Feeling it out. It's always a good idea, especially if you're not totally aware of who's playing against.
I mean, this is what we expect. This is a kind of slow matchup too. You're not going to see like explosive. Maybe Samus has the ability to do like explosive things on Kirby, but I mean, at the level of placement she is at, I don't think we're really going to see anything explosive from Samus. Kirby doesn't really have anything explosive in this matchup. So it's kind of a slow matchup, and it's usually like one person slowly getting outplayed, which is kind of what we're seeing right now.
Yep.
Like Revan up two stocks, but we haven't seen him do anything crazy.
He's just waiting for the trash. He really can't.
Yeah. And that's really the matchup from Samus's point of view, right? The down air back air we just saw is kind of everything Samus has.
Yep.
Which
is tough if you don't know how to like properly disguise mechanics.
Yeah, Samus's down air is so fast. Samus's down air is so fast that you can kind of get away with just kind of like throwing it out. Oh, and Samus also has. I feel like Revan could have gotten more out of that grab. I feel like he kind of got impatient with like threw out an up smash. But, alright, what we saw there was Samus landing with fair, and Samus landing with fair is like, it's horrible. It's so bad.
Ooh!
Revan's actually really good at that, with the ledge hog thing. That's not easy to do. It's not like one of the hardest decks in the game, but it's not like free by any means. With Kirby, at least. And Revan's really good at it. That's like the second time I've seen him read a recovery like that.
Smash users definitely struggling to figure out how he's supposed to
go. I think Revan could have done a cutter there. I feel like, alright, so it's kind of like a quiet atmosphere in the room, right? I feel like people have kind of assumed that Revan might win this, and everyone's waiting for the Revan Fire Blast rematch. Oh, that was really good.
Okay, but this isn't a far cry for people. Like, Revan obviously isn't capitalizing as much as it could be, but it's very close to being close.
Yes, but Kirby is also a character that once Kirby gets a lead, it's kind of hard to take that lead back.
Right. And then he doesn't have to go.
And Samus, like I said, isn't. Like, at this level of play, Samus isn't a character that can just like snatch stocks out of nowhere. But, when someone gets a lead in this matchup, it often results in that person winning. It's not a matchup like Pika Falcon where like a 3-stock lead doesn't mean anything. Like, a lead actually means something in this matchup. Like this matchup is like a very percentage based. It's a slower paced game. It's not like that typical 64 style like zero to death. It's a lot more spacing in mind games. Ooh. Oh my god, that was actually a really, really amazing anti right there.
Yeah, the timing would be strict in between the Samus puppy hitbox.
Yeah.
But before he grabbed
it.
Very
late. Oh man. I got 3 hours away. I got class at 9 tomorrow.
That'll be brutal.
Yeah, it's gonna suck. Okay. Alright, so Smash Justice's secondary is Falcon, which people think is a bad match for Falcon. So we're definitely not gonna see that. It's gonna be this all three times. I don't, like, I can't really, like, point out anything that, like, Commissions has done wrong. It's, like...
Well, he's a little over the middle, and Revan is just kind of, like, facing better.
Yeah, Revan's kind of just, like slowly out-basing him and outplaying him.
It's like every time Smash Beast is a little too close to his air approach,
yeah.
He gets them back here to face the death.
Yeah.
And then, losing momentum, Revan just gets it.
Yeah. Although, Smash Jesus isn't necessarily... oh my god, that Dante was amazing. Smash Jesus is generally a very composed player. I don't think he's one to, like, let momentum affect him so much. Oh! Ah, that dash attack was absolutely supposed to be an F smash.
Oh, and the shield break.
Ooh! that was really nice. Good. That, those are the explosions that we'll see in this matchup. Like, nothing too crazy, but, like, little optimal strings that, that'll work.
Nope.
Oh, man. Yeah, so Revan just did an accidental dash attack. He recently picked up a Hori pad, but I don't know if you know what that is. It's like the N64 controller, but way more sensitive, I guess, and the stick doesn't wear out. And, yeah, so a lot of times he'll try to pivot up tilt and do a dash attack.
I'm assuming it's more, it outweighs.
It can. Some players really like it. Like me, I would never be able to use a Hori pad. Anyway, but this matchup, or this match, is kind of like it's in Revan's lead, obviously. But I don't think that Revan is in. Oh, wow, that was so good. Revan doesn't have like the control he did last game, but I mean it's still early on. Like I said, this matchup is kind of like one of those matchups where you slowly
lose the whole game.
Yeah, you kind of just lose slowly over time. It's not a very exciting matchup. There is like incredible. He rolls, is completely invincible during your entire roll, and they can act out of it again. So you could like roll and then buffer shield, and you're invincible 100% of the time. Oh, that was, I don't know if that was. Yeah, that was a joke. Kirby's the worst shield in the game. Oh!
Man, that's a little bit style.
Oh my god, that was nasty.
That is not a real combo. People don't use it out there.
I know, I think that was actually a combo. I just don't. Wow, that was crazy. I doubt that up there was even on purpose.
But hey, he rolled with it. It worked out really well. Yeah. Really nice.
Wow, Revan is a short hop down air on shield to apply pressure. Mesh's shield is coming down. There's like a way if Wispy blows, that can result in a skill break. Sometimes not too, I don't really know the specifics. This matchup looking more...
Ooh, the break.
I kind of thought the better one. Oh my god. Those are like the other string alongs, like the... That was really good by Revan. Revan's really impressed me this tournament.
So, I mean, I'll come back with... A lot, basically.
Yeah.
You have to play perfect for all 4 minutes, probably.
Yeah. Oh, man. If he got the reverse back air, weak back air, he could have ended up with a up air.
Good recovery. I mean, definitely fighting.
Wow, that was such. That was such an amazing pullback.
Definitely doing a good job of just never giving Smash Bros. A chance.
Yeah.
Closing out every option and making it pretty unwinnable.
Yeah, the game was close. Yeah. Right, but then at the point, Smash got that box, played Revan. I know, the boss did super well. I mean, we'll see how this goes. Like I said, like, a pretty big skill difference, and this matchup, it's not like one of Samus' worst, but like I said, it's definitely not in Samus' favor.
Yeah. And given... well, I mean, Kirby does a lot.
Yeah.
This kid, he does better.
Yeah. You know, actually, I think that's kind of what makes this matchup not so hard for Samus, because all the stuff that usually makes Kirby a great character doesn't really work as well. Oh my god. Smash is definitely gonna be that back on stage. I don't think he was ready for that. start for Smashy this to try to phone out Revan at the neutral bit.
Yep. Definitely has gotten punished every single time.
Does this play sell energy?
Yeah.
I feel like definitely. Not the exciting commentary that existed earlier.
Well, but we said for less exciting time.
Yeah.
For instance, your math is
less what?
So, exceptionally high.
Oh, who commented?
That was myself.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's the match. That's the match at hand. 5 stocks to 3. Pretty much what we've been seeing, like, Revan kind of slowly beating Smash Jesus. And, like the thing is, you can't really point at something Smash Jesus is doing and be like, wow, he's gonna punch for that. It's just slowly being outspaced and slowly kind of, like, not doing the right thing. That was questionable.
It's less refined neutral, less refined.
Yeah, it's... Yeah.
Not he's not tricking Revan. Revan's really good in the way he goes out.
Yeah, this is like a good example of just someone like losing because they're a worse player. Not because of like a matchup necessarily, or not because of like gimmicks or inexperience. Like, it's just straight up like he's playing a better player. That's all it is. Like, Smash Jesus is good, but I mean, it's not enough to like really play Revan, I think, at this point. This is the biggest lead we've seen Revan have.
Alright, yeah.
I mean, I'm trying to think of things that Smash Jesus could do to do, like, better, like,
Well, he's been really teleported. Like, you can kind of split him in any situation.
But I mean, that's not necessarily Smash Jesus' fault, but yeah. Samus is a character. Like, Samus doesn't have much going for her. Like, she really doesn't. She has, like, a good back air and a good down air. Everything else is pretty... Oh, God, that was brutal. Everything else Samus is going for is pretty mediocre. So it's not, like... It's okay. Not so much Smash Jesus is playing a real linear playstyle. It's just Samus as a character is rather linear. And, like, Samus is a bad grab, so little moments like that where every other character, well, all but, like, 9 characters, would get a grab, Samus kind of just has to, like, hope that Revan jumps into a down air or something.
Oh my god.
Dude, that was so smart. Revan went to the other side of the platform so that up tilt wouldn't pressure Smash. That was really good. Yeah, and this is one of those things, like, sometimes I break shield, sometimes it doesn't. I'm not gonna pretend like I know when it doesn't, but...
I think the shield broke. Definitely. I know that there's two parts. I guess Kirby, like, has, like,
yeah, you're right. Maybe it's character specific and not so much situationally specific. Yeah, but that definitely breaks shields, like, sometimes. I just don't know. Ooh, great down air.
Definitely caught him off guard.
Yeah, Revan, like, kind of put his head down a little bit.
Not that he...
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was like, Revan, why are you so down? You're a huge fan. So, Revan, like, one attack, Revan, that's probably super stealth. This is so hard to come back from.
Yeah, just kind of hoping to catch.
Like, at this point, I feel like it's more about just, like, trying to have a good showing and not necessarily... Ooh, like, that was a very creative recovery. That was good by Smash Jesus. Oh, yeah, that's gonna be bad. Samus' tech roll isn't the best. I feel like I'm about to fall asleep. I need minutes.
So, go around.